Bagon? Shelgon? Salamence? Flygon! Yo, whoa, what is going on YouTube? It's your boy Dan, aka Drive. Pretty guys, a brand new video today, and today we're gonna take a look at a handful of amazing Pokemon conspiracy theories that really may be true and not just a conspiracy theory. So we're gonna break them all down in this video, including one that is gonna just absolutely blow your mind. I don't even know what to think. It's just crazy stuff, man. It's really crazy stuff. If you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to hit that like button down below and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I post Pokemon videos every single day and you do not want to miss out on our amazing Pokemon content. If there's any conspiracy theories or cool ideas that you have, let me know in the comments section below. Maybe we'll make a follow-up video and maybe you'll be featured in it. That would be pretty sweet, wouldn't it? Without further ado, let's dive into the world of Pokemon conspiracy theories. All right, so I mentioned in the intro, we're just gonna jump into it. We've got this one here with Flygon and Salamence. And it's not so much that these Pokemon have any sort of connectivity to them themselves, but rather that their names were swapped. Now, when you think about it, you go from Bagon to Shelgon to Salamence, and then you have Trapinch, Vibrava, and Flygon. I would think that those names were flopped, and it makes a lot of sense. I mean, if you just look at the Pokemon line is fine. There's nothing weird about their evolution path, but their names seem like they're swapped. It's very strange to me. Like, how do you go from Bagon, Shelgon to Salamence, and then you have another dragon that's very similar named Flygon? Why did they not call Salamence Flygon, and why do they not call Flygon Salamence? You get where I'm coming from? Just a name swap. That's all I'm looking for. All right, so I know you guys have definitely heard of this theory, but it's about Cubone and its relation to Kangaskhan and maybe even Charizard. So the first one's pretty obvious, right? A lot of people speculate that Cubone is actually the baby Kangaskhan that's sitting in its pouch and then has the skull of its dead mother, and it kind of wears that around, which is totally not weird at all. Not weird at all. But there's a couple things that maybe point towards it being Charizard. One thing in favor of it being the Kangaskhan family line is in Pokemon Sun and Moon, where you use the SOS method. Cubone can actually call in a Kangaskhan. Is it calling for help just from anything? Maybe. Is it calling for its potential mother or aunt who's not dead? Also, maybe. But there's another theory about it being related to Charmander and the Charizard line. And the logic behind that is Marowak looks very similar to Charmeleon if you look at him closely. And then when you take a look at Cubone and the fact that it's got that skull on its head, it looks like it could potentially be a Charizard skull on its head. So there's a thought that maybe it's a Charmander that doesn't have its tail lit, and therefore it ends up having the skull of the dead mother of the Charizard on its head instead. And it's this whole hoopla. So I gotta ask you guys, do you think it's related to Kangaskhan? Do you think it's related to Charizard, or neither, actually? Now, this one is one that I'm actually a big fan of, and I love looking at this one. And that is the swap between the Venonat line and the Butterfree line. And what do I mean by that? Well, if you haven't seen it yet, Venonat and Butterfree have so many similarities from kind of an aesthetic perspective. The eyes match, the antennas match, the feet are very similar. Even the mouthpiece is very similar. Venonat and Butterfree look like they evolve into each other. And then when you look at Caterpie, Metapod, and Venomoth, there's some similarities there too. The headpiece that goes from Caterpie to Venomoth, some of the rings on the bottom of the Caterpie and the Metapod to the Venomoth, and the big one is the eyes. The eyes of Caterpie and Metapod are very similar to the eyes of Venomoth, and I feel like those kind definitely can tie together. I feel like there's a really big chance that somewhere along the development of Pokemon, they flipped them. Or maybe they were just inspired by each other, but at first glance, a non-Pokemon fan, if you told me which one of these evolves into which, and you put Venonat and Caterpie next to each other, I would 1,000,000% assume that Venonat evolved into Butterfree, and Caterpie, Metapod, evolves into Venomoth by kind of process of elimination at that point. But very interesting theory here, and one of the ones that I absolutely love. The next one is another popular one, and that's the relationship between Clefable and Gengar. Now, a lot of people have speculated that maybe Gengar is the ghost of a dead Clefable, or maybe it's just its shadow, but ultimately, the similarities between the two design are so obvious. Like, it looks like it's a silhouette, basically. Like, Gengar is almost a silhouette of Clefable. So it makes us wonder, is there a relationship between these two? It has never really been addressed in the Pokemon fandom as far as I know, but I do feel like there's a lot of similarity, like I said, just from a visual perspective. Did Clefable die, turn into a Gengar? Is it just a shadow? Back in Gen 1, Clefable was a normal type, Gengar was a ghost type, and obviously those two types can't hit each other, so I do wonder if there's some sort of a connection there. Now there's fairy and poison typing, and it's all over the place, but, you know, we're going back in time to Gen 1, really. There's a long-standing Pokemon theory that the legendary beast trio, Raikou, Entei, Suicune, was actually originally Jolteon, Flareon, and Vaporeon. And the logic behind that is when the Brass Tower in Ecruteak City burned, three Pokemon perished in the fire, and then they were revived by Ho-Oh, and that it became what the legendary beasts were, Entei, Raikou, Suicune. So here's the thing, when we look at these Pokemon and we compare Raikou to Jolteon and Entei to Flareon, Suicune to Vaporeon, obviously they share the same typings, but they also share the same color scheme. And I know that might seem a little bit far-fetched, but when we actually take a look in Gen 5 and look at their hidden abilities that were originally released, they happen to be Volt Absorb for Raikou, Flash Fire for Entei, and Water Absorb for Suicune, and those were the exact abilities of the original Eeveelutions. Mind blown. Now this one's a little confusing, and I'm not sure I'm fully buying into this one, but it's the idea behind Dratini, Dragonair, Dragonite, actually supposed to be Dratini, Dragonair, Gyarados, and then Magikarp into Dragonite, and really that's based around mostly color scheme, right? Like, we look at the colors on the Magikarp, the red and the orangey color, and then you look at Dragonite, obviously, having that orange color across his body, and then obviously Dratini, Dragonair, and then Gyarados with the blue coloration. The reality of it is, it all just comes down to the fact that Dratini, Dragonair look nothing like Dragonite. Like, what's up with that? How do you go from this super slender snake to Barney over here? How does that happen? I'm not hating on Dragonite. I'm just saying, that is an evolution if I've ever done seen one. There's a lot of theories in the Pokemon fandom about Mew, Mewtwo, how those Pokemon are related. But what about Mew and Ditto? I feel like that's one that a lot of people have brought up. The two Pokemon that know transform in Gen 1, both Mew and Ditto. You've got the two color schemes. They both match. They're both pink. Their shinies are both blue. They're both very DNA-based, right? They talk about changing and transforming into different Pokemon. Very, very interesting. Is Ditto like a failed Mew clone? What happened there? And then you can even dive even further into it and look at things like Ditto and how it relates to maybe Grimer. They were both in Cinnabar Island. Did Ditto evolve into its environment and turn into a poison-type Pokemon because of all the gas in the air from the coughings and stuff? We're really going down the rabbit hole here. But again, Ditto, a very, very interesting Pokemon in the world of Pokemon conspiracy theories, and I am very curious if it has any sort of relationship to Mew, to Grimer, to any of these Pokemon that we've seen in Generation 1 or beyond. I think there's gotta be some sort of a connection there. And last but certainly not least, and actually the idea that kind of sparked this video in the first place, is the fact that Calyrex's loyal steed in the Crown Tundra was actually a Galarian Rapidash. Yes, this fan theory popped up on Reddit the other day, and it has taken the world by storm. Gaming with Brendan, I believe, originally posted it. And the idea behind this theory is that the Rapidash actually froze to death in the Crown Tundra, right, as part of the story. And then it broke off into two different steeds. Glastrier, the frozen version of it, and then Spectrier, which was the one that kind of showed up as its ghost of the frozen corpse, right? And when you look at the two and you compare, there's a lot of similarities. You've got the big horn on top of Glastrier. You've obviously, he loses his tail, but he's got the same feet, obviously. Then you look at Spectrier, it's got the same hair, the same hooves. There's a lot of similarities when you look at these images, and it's a really, really awesome fan theory that I'm all about, man. I love that. I think that's super duper cool. And there's a lot of Pokemon conspiracy theories out there that we've yet to even hear about or break down. So let me know in the comments section below if you guys have any other ideas or if there's anything you were thinking about from watching this video. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to smash that like button down below. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I post Pokemon videos every single day, and you do not want to miss out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. If you guys enjoyed this video, you should definitely check out this one right here. Otherwise, check out this video as well. Subscribe to the channel and check out my YouTube Shorts channel as well for great daily content.